I'm still at it, still working on setting posts for the little bit of a new addition here. Now, it may not look like a whole lot got done on this project today, and probably a little less than I did yesterday in reality, but I was able to set a few posts. I'm starting to establish this side of the building. This post is going to go in next, and that establishes my corners. Then there's only one more post that'll be the edge of the door, and it's that door that we'll sneak the power hammer in under. So things really are happening, and it's starting to move along. And with any luck, by the end of the weekend, today's Thursday, I'll work a little bit tomorrow. Got other stuff I got to do Saturday, so I'll get some work done Sunday. So hopefully by the time Sunday's over, I'll have a little bit more done here, and it'll actually start to look like what it's going to be in the long run. And of course, like any construction site, the place is a shambles. Now, these two posts here define this end of the wall. And people have asked or suggested adding more. Say, well, if you're going to do 4 feet, do 6 feet, do 8 feet. And part of the reason that I'm not going to do more than the 4 feet is this space right here. From this post to this wall is about 30 inches. I spent several years working a little here and a little there, getting this retaining wall in that goes around the addition that's going to be part of the shop office. And I don't want to lose my outdoor access. That was part of the whole point of the little office, was to have a little back door, little place that comes out here on what's the shady side of the shop most of the time. And if this post moved over another 2 feet, it would be right up against this, and I completely block off my access, and the back door of my office would just walk into the back of the power hammer, and it's not really what I want. So 4 feet is really the maximum without a major remodel. That would also involve raising the roof, because the edge of this addition is going to be just a little over 6 feet tall. If I brought it out to here, it would be well under that, and I think that is just too low for the sidewall of a shop. So really, 4 feet is about all I can do. As things go, this is a relatively simple little bump out that is going to make all the difference in the world to fit the new power hammer in. Another common question is, will the thing even fit under the eaves of the shop? And the answer is just barely. The maximum height of the hammer to the top of a little tiny adjusting valve on the top of the hammer is 76.5 inches. If I put it on rollers that are about 2 inches tall, it's going to be a little bit taller than that. And that will just clear these rafter tails. Unfortunately, it won't clear my beam, which is why this post is here. I'm going to have to cut the beam and slide the hammer in, and then hopefully I can replace the beam later. Or I'm going to have to do a little bit of engineering to figure out what has to hold this one rafter up. This post will hold from here that way, and this post holds up from there that way. So it's just one rafter that I'm going to be removing the beam from under. And I think I can find a workaround for that that will be more than strong enough. I can probably double this rafter, put a header across here, put a hanger on this rafter, and that would do the job. And there's some other things I have in mind. So it is certainly possible. And at that point, the hammer will slide in through here very nicely. If for some reason we have a problem, the dealer says that we can actually take that valve and a few of the other assemblies off the top of the hammer and bring the hammer height down to about 69 inches, slide it into the building, and then put the stuff back on top of the hammer. He says it takes about an hour to do it that way, but apparently he's done that before, so it does work. And at 69 inches, we could actually slide in under this beam, but I think it would affect being able to maintain the hammer because it would make the top cover difficult to get on and off. So it probably has to go one way or the other. Now, for the front of the concrete slab that I will pour to set the hammer on, to the back of this post, which is how far the slab will be and the allowable space for the hammer, will be 87 inches. The base for the hammer is 75 inches. So I have an extra 12 inches of space. I can actually bring the hammer further back this way than what the little giant and the bull hammer are sitting. And that will give me just a few more inches of useful space in the shop. So it's all pretty good. And this addition, I think, is going to work out just fine, even if it is the minimum that I can get by with. So it's back to work for me. I hope you enjoyed this little update. Give it a thumbs up if you did. Again, love it if you hit that subscribe button. But we'll see you around the corner, and hopefully there'll be more work done tomorrow.